Hi, and welcome to another edition of Hacking Maths. Today's lesson is to perform a chi-squared test of independence. This method will calculate the chi-squared value, the p-value, and the number of degrees of freedom. So grab your calculator and follow along with the calculation. On the right-hand side, you can see the observed contingency table. To calculate the chi-squared value, we need to enter this table into the calculator. So let's begin. We start by pressing second and then x to the minus 1. This takes you to the matrix menu. Once here, we scroll across to the right, so edit is highlighted. Then we press enter. You now need to enter the number of rows and the number of columns that the observed table has. Note, we do not include the total rows and columns. That means there are two rows, so we press 2 and then enter. There are two columns, so we press 2 and then enter. We need to put the values into the observed table on the calculator, so we just type the numbers in and press enter after each one. Now that you have filled in the table, we can calculate the chi-squared value. Press the Stat button on the calculator. Scroll all the way to the right so that Tests is highlighted. Then scroll up until you get to Chi-squared Test and make sure it is also highlighted. Note, there is also a chi-squared GOF test. You don't want to use that, so just highlight chi-squared like I have done and then press enter. The calculator gives you several options, but you don't need to worry about them just now. Press enter 3 times, and if you have followed what I have done, then you will get the chi-squared value, the p-value, and the number of degrees of freedom. Well, that's all for this lesson. I hope to see you next time on Hacking Maths.